Hello everybody, and welcome to the first ever episode of Xen'S Cooking. This is the show where our two contestants with little to no cooking experience go head to head to impress our guest judges. Over the course of the series, we hope that our contestants will improve their cooking ability and be able to use it in their later life. Today, they'll be given an envelope with their mystery country in, which they must plan a meal for and cook that meal within an hour. They'll be off to the shop to get their ingredients, come back and cook. Without further ado, let me introduce our first of two contestants, Henry.
So,
welcome, Henry. How are you feeling?
I'm all right. I'm ready to kick the ass with whoever's near me.
What's your cooking experience before you came in?
This is a cooking show?
Yes.
Have
you made anything? Nice to see you came prepared.
Yeah.
And on that note, I think it's time to introduce our other contestant, Tom. Welcome, Tom. This is Henry. Henry, this is Tom. I believe you two know each other already. Is that right?
I've never met him in my life.
Never met this man.
That handshake proves otherwise.
I would disagree.
Mate, you're seeing things.
Yeah, like what handshake?
Tom, what would you say is your prior knowledge to cooking?
I'm a 10 out of 10.
10 out of 10.
Yeah.
So we can expect big things this series.
Yeah.
Good family dinners, yeah.
Pot noodles, easy. Like, eat it like this and okay. I may have poisoned like 3 people, but listen, they were good noodles.
Good noodles. Okay then. So I'm about to give you both an envelope. In this envelope will be a country which you must base the ideas of your meal on. You'll be given some time to think of an idea and then go to the shop of your choice to go get your ingredients. When you're back, I'll come and see you, and then you'll have an hour to cook your meal. So bear that in mind. Without further ado, here are your envelopes, and feel free to open up when you're ready.
I bet it's Indian.
I'm saying China.
Don't stop me!
Fancy fucking soy sauce.
Noodles.
I don't know. There's like soy sauce, no noodles. Do they even have anything here?
No.
My thought process was just grab noodles, chicken, some veg, and some sauce for it.
Noodles?
Anyone? Pork crackers.
Two of those.
Sure. Soy sauce!
It just eluded me for about 2 minutes and then I turned around the corner and it was right there.
Did you look at that?
Yeah.
Oh, when I was going shopping, it was awful. Like, that, it was horrendous.
That's a lot of the noodle.
That'll be.
Oh, the fuck. Oh, I'm gonna kill myself.
I think I'm good.
Fucking lob this at Henry's head, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's soy and mint. Is that actual meat? Oh no, that's soy and everything.
Welcome.
8 poppadoms, you know what I'm saying? Rice. It's all rice. Where's the actual like stuff? Like any fruit, veg? No, I don't know. There's nothing here, innit? Solid. I know what I'm doing now.
Where am I going?
As we all know, Bombay is Indian for Beijing. It's a Beijing bad boy.
Where am I going?
I don't know why I got this as well. It's just got like the Chinese thing on it, so. successfully nicked an Asda bag. You know, what can I say? That's 5p.
Welcome back, guys. Did you get everything you needed?
Probably not.
Yeah.
Okay, good. You both feeling confident?
No.
Yeah.
Henry, you seem to be at a bit of a disadvantage here.
Oh, I'll be good. I'll firm it.
Is it a height disadvantage?
How much did it cost,
Henry? Talk about shit for someone in slapping distance, motherfucker.
Yeah, if you're on to
I think it was £10.52.
So you spent £10 of the budget. How much did you spend, Tom?
Like £8.40.
£8. Okay, I must stress, from now on, you cannot look at any recipes or access your phone at all.
All right.
Are you both ready?
No. Yes.
Here's your aprons. All right. If you get them on.
Which way does it go?
With the pockets at the front.
Pockets at the front.
I knew that, yeah.
Yeah. Smart man.
Smart man you are. It's very long.
Yeah, it's a bit big for me.
This is your fault.
Well, my fault?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's just gonna tie a double knot, isn't he?
Tie a double knot. Beautiful, good enough.
So when you're both ready, you have an hour to make your meal. 3, 2, 1, let's cook.
All right, cool. I need a cut thing.
You stole my knife.
You were my baby!
Use your hands.
I need to cut it. I can't do anything until I cut that. Give me a knife. Just give me one. I don't care which one.
Oh, just take one.
You know, I know you can open it a good way, but it's funnier to do it this way.
I'm so fucked. I don't know what I'm doing. Like, I got noodles. I don't like noodles.
So,
like, what am I making?
Manila.
I've got it. Yeah. Also, this chopping board's small. My one at home, that big. Goes there.
I can't be able to cut you. You're too big. All right, cool. That's that cut. Fucking hell.
Is broccoli good? I don't know if it's actually good in a stir fry. Big bits? Small bits?
How the fuck does oil work?
Do you mean how does oil work? Idiot.
That's fucking rude. Fix it. I've got oil everywhere.
And then I'm doing it like that. Because I don't like big bits of broccoli. I don't like broccoli in general.
I can fuck off over there.
I don't know why they gave us an hour. It's going to take like 20 minutes. But what am I going to do for the rest of it? Eat it? To be fair.
You suck.
How do I cut this? Not like that. This is 4 minutes. Alright, I'm gonna boil them, then thingy. I should probably boil the water first.
When in doubt, throw more oil on it. This might catch fire.
Oh my days. Don't tell me I picked up two slices by accident.
So if there's God out there, please don't give my people salmonella. I don't want to be responsible for any more murders.
Boom. I'll fry them for 2 minutes and I'll put these in, which is for 4 minutes.
Fuck! I think it splashed on me. That's a nice sound. My question is, do I put in the noodles? Or the salad first. Soy sauce.
4 servings apparently. Oh, that doesn't seem enough.
You're going now. Hope the judge likes soy sauce. Or isn't allergic to soy.
Fuck, what if they're allergic to soy? This is more McGregor. Which one's it came from? That's grease proof. That's foil. No. I don't want the meat drying out. No one wants dry meat. And I've used way too much. We ate like 7 turtles are dying from this. I'm sorry, turtles. You're kind of sick, I can't lie.
Wait a minute, what if there's something you have to do to these? Because these are dry. The hardest part was probably boiling the noodles, because I definitely didn't read that I needed to boil them. I just kind of chucked them in, and then I had to fish them out, and I didn't. It was just annoying. Nothing went wrong. I didn't fuck up or anything. What are you on about? Well, that went well. Hey Tom, look, I'm hot.
I made that joke like fucking, that was,
well,
like, that was like 15 minutes ago.
Shut up, didn't happen. Didn't see it, didn't happen.
How long was that for? 4 minutes. Oh shit, I can't use my phone for a timer. Where's the clock? 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, 6 past.
Can't be 25 minutes,
right?
Bang,
if you know, you know.
Tom, it hasn't been like 35 minutes, has it?
Well, I fucking know.
Boil!
Yo, yours ain't boiling, mate. Do you want some help?
I just want boil.
Turn it to the high setting.
It is on the high setting.
Oh, then yeah, you're fucked.
Yeah. Fuck you, asshole.
Do you put salt in your thing? I don't know. I might.
You're gonna use the pink salt?
Yeah, because it's good for bodybuilding.
Oh.
Oh my god.
Why aren't you hot?
How are you meant to open it? Oh.
One point, the water wouldn't boil for like 10 minutes, which was very annoying. You want some tomatoes?
No, I'm good.
You got 2 like little tomatoes. Oh, you got Mars bar? You gonna deep fry a Mars bar?
Yeah, it's Glaswegian. It's the Glasgow diet.
Glasgow diet?
You know, thyme, as in the crisps. Fruit, as in fruit pasta.
It's not hot. I knew it! It's not hot!
It's a bit now.
Flip the noodle.
It's a bit more moisture, isn't it?
Oh, look, it's actually getting hot now. Final.
You are halfway through your time, 30 seconds remaining.
Motherfucker.
That's just lies though, isn't it?
So Henry, how do you think yours is going?
I put the noodles in too early, then I realised I had to boil them, and then I tried boiling them.
Are they boiling now?
I hope so.
Bubbles. Are you confident you're going to finish with 30 seconds left?
Maybe.
Well, good luck.
We'll find out.
And then, yeah. Oh shit, that was a bad idea. Okay.
And Tom, how do you think you're going?
Come back in 3 minutes.
All right.
Oh, it just says drain and serve. Okay.
Oh. I'm gonna need a colander. I'm gonna need a colander. Colander. I'm gonna need a colander. I'm gonna need a colander. This is good enough. Yeah, you've better fucking boil.
You put it in that way. These noodles are gonna be so fucked. I'll just leave it on that. I'll just remember to maintain that and that.
So Tom, how's it going?
Swimmingly, mate.
Do you think you're gonna finish?
Yeah, maybe. If this will fucking start sizzling. There we go.
Good luck. Good luck.
Noodle faster.
Yeah, cheers. In this world, you're either a smart fella or a fart smeller.
Yeah, you're either a smart fella or a fart smeller.
That's gonna be so awful to eat. Whoopsies. Oh, it's working, it's working, it's working, it's working.
Cool, I'm gonna drain you now. And I'm gonna hope it fucking works.
I'll put them in, I'll put the thing in too late though.
It's not how to cook. Quick.
Don't use me as an example.
You giving up?
Yeah.
I keep burning my hand because I keep putting it over the one that I just used.
But the carrots aren't even done as well. Nope.
That fucking hurts. I'm not touching it. Yo, Tom, I'll give you a crisp high five if you touch this. Close. Yes. Yes, I had some chili.
It said four servings, but I was like, no, nah, that ain't enough, that ain't enough. It fucking clearly wasn't.
Beautiful.
That water was manky, I tell you.
What was manky?
The water. Too much limescale, you know what I'm saying, mate?
Oh, yeah, too much limescale. Limescale, dirt and shine. Bang, and the dirt is gone.
The bacon is actually coming along good. So if all else fails, I'm not gonna be poisoning anyone today.
Do you know how much time we have?
20 minutes.
Cool.
It's just a hot carrot, like.
Yo, is it just a hot carrot?
Yeah.
Sucked for you.
Should I boil the carrot?
Why have you got so little noodles?
Because it said four servings. I was like, no, that's not enough.
That's but
not.
I
was
like, I think it means there's four bricks, which is one serving.
No, it just straight up says four servings.
Yeah, there's four bricks of noodles.
Yeah, I know there's four bricks.
So one brick would be one serving.
Yeah, but I'm just like, hang on, nah, that's like, I looked at it, I was like, that's too little. And then
the whole thing would be four servings, not just one thing.
What do you mean? You're just saying the same shit as me.
Why did you use one? Because you thought four servings was too little.
No, I thought one serving was too little, but I said, oh, it says four servings in there, so one of these is one
serving. You always double
that. Well, I'm boiling this now, aren't I? Go back to your fucking like salmonella or some shit.
Yeah, I am making salmonella. It's great. I made a mess.
Lad. Come on.
When I saw that I finished like way earlier than Tom and way within the time limit, I just thought I've probably got this in the bag. Now we wait to be told when there's like 5 minutes left so I can plate up the charges.
These noodles are gonna be so fucking impossible to chew as well. I just gotta make sure. Oh my days. Okay, there we go. Okay, noodles are fine for now. Don't have to worry about them. Do I do this? That's the big question. Hey, now we're cooking. Done.
5 minutes remaining. Henry, how's it going? Are you finished?
Pretty much, yeah. I just got to take it off, plate it up, and then I'm good.
Okay, now's a good time to start doing that.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Oh, that's an ugly colour.
So Tom, how's it going?
It's going class.
Do you think you're gonna get done in 5 minutes? I'll take that as a no. Are you done?
It's good, no?
I taste Asda. Will you finish in the 5 minutes?
Maybe.
Well, good luck.
I was just gonna squirt all over, but no. I want that. Little sauce for the poppadoms.
Oh, dope. That is your time. Please stop whatever it is you're doing. Tom?
I'm stopping. I've stopped.
Is this involved in your dish?
Next question.
Okay, so how do you think your dish went?
Just look at it.
Yeah, do you want to talk me through what you've got here?
An existential crisis.
Okay.
I started with some ingredients, had a breakdown. Bon appetit.
Cool. Looks like a very good challenger for the first episode.
You mean challenged?
Challenger. For that number one spot.
Yeah. Think of me, moron.
Well, good luck. I'm gonna go speak to Henry now. So Henry, your time's up. How do you think you went?
That's all right. I finished really early, so I just kind of waited and I made food for myself.
Good. Do you want to tell me what you've got here?
Yeah, it's sweet chili and chicken stir fry. It's got prawn crackers. And...
Yeah. Do you think you've got what it takes to beat Tom today?
I mean, probably. He kind of fucked up a lot.
That is true.
Okay. Well, I'd like to say if your things are now both done, I'm going to introduce our guest judge.
Okay.
For episode one's special guest judge, we have brought in Anise. So I hear one of your family members is a chef.
Yes, my mum.
Well, today's country theme is China. Would you like to come over and see Henry first?
Okay.
So Henry, would you like to talk us through what you've got?
It's sweet chili, chicken, stir fry, prawn crackers.
Okay, so I liked your presentation. I liked your use of Chinese culture with the Chinese flag.
Thank you.
I liked the how you did the prawn crackers, although I'm not sure how the prawn crackers actually ties in with the meal.
It's just a side, isn't
it? Okay.
It's kind of there.
The chicken was, it was cooked, and I am happy with that.
Yeah, I didn't poison you or anything.
Yeah, and it was quite dry though.
Yeah. I finished a bit early and then I just kind of left it on the heat so it could...
I think the noodles could have had a bit, like, I don't know, a bit longer, maybe.
Yeah, maybe.
But the flavour, I could taste it. It was there. Overall, it was okay.
Okay, when you're ready, we'll take a walk over to Tom's.
Okay.
Tom, would you like to talk us through what you've got here?
Okay, so I started with some ingredients. I had a mental breakdown. Here we are.
Do you want to tell me what's in it and what it is?
I went with some egg noodles here and some flour noodles here. You know, I thought I'd use the best of both worlds. There's some broccoli, carrots and cauliflower in there, along with some nice, I would say crispy, but it's been a while since I plated it. So some bacon, and then I got some Chinese poppadoms. I got them from a man in the street who said that they were Chinese. And there's some hoisin sauce to complement the poppadoms. And this is just some sweet and sour noodles that I concocted in about 4 minutes.
Brilliant.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
Oh, I almost forgot. There's a Mars bar.
Thanks.
Can I just ask how the Mars bar is Chinese?
It's made in China. I don't want to start anything, all right? All right, listen. If you just don't disqualify me for that, you know what I'm saying? Don't disqualify me, okay?
Okay. Do you want to be disqualified?
Tom's gonna fucking say that he didn't. I definitely saw some bribery, but at the same time, then it's probably seeing some things.
It never happened. You're seeing things, mate. Like, you must have taken acid before doing this, because I saw nothing.
Give me one more spell back. Here.
Right, okay.
Do you want to tell us what's good?
Everything, surely.
Sure. I liked the communal aspects of it and how it looks like someone else has already been there. The hoisin duck sauce.
I went for the authentic Chinese restaurant feel, you know? Where they straight out the pan.
Oh, bomb. I understand now. Okay. I liked how you also went for the Chinese flag. It really brings me, you know, closer to China.
Yeah, it brings you joy.
I thought the poffedon was brought a nice sort of Asian influence fusion, sort of. The flour noodles, they're not flour noodles, they are egg noodles, I will tell you that.
I've been lied to again.
The broccoli, I quite liked the broccoli. I was quite a fan of that. It was flavoured well and the bacon was cooked, which I'm proud of.
That's the best we could have hoped for.
Yeah.
So if you two want to go way outside and we'll talk about the scores and we'll bring you back with a verdict. That needs to stay. We're talking about that. So I'm joined here by Anise, and we're going to talk over these in a bit more detail. So we'll start with Tom's. What did you think of that?
I thought it was interesting. I thought he was being creative. Yeah, the bacon was cooked. I heard from, like, you know, word to mouth, you hear it, that it was going to be a little bit undercooked. So I was pleasantly surprised by that. Tom has surprised me, actually, with his skills. I think, you know, just like his choice of seasoning and sauce, and I liked how he brought across different cultures to sort of expand on the Chinese theme, because, you know, it's not all about China. He brought together an Indian aspect for a more southern route. You got the bacon there and the Mars bar for something like that, something that I'm used to, something that I grew up with, which is British food.
So on the theme of Chinese, what part of it is actually Chinese?
There was the hoisin duck sauce, which I dipped the poppadom in. That's Chinese. Oh, he had the flag on it.
Yeah.
The flag, yeah, that's a really big part. Yeah.
I noticed you used the word communal when you described it. What was running through your head when you said that?
Well, you see, lots of families, they like to eat together, don't they? So it's sort of like a buffet style. And they will share food, and that just sort of brought that to me.
And then we're moving on to Henry's here.
Yes, I think the choice to add the prawn crackers on the noodles was a strange choice for me. I understand that it would probably help the prawn crackers, mix up and soak up the flavours, but that would make them soggy also. So you put the chicken on top to show it's a chicken dish. But I will say it was quite bland. I could see the flavours in there and I could taste them, but it wasn't really enough for me.
Not strong enough.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for your comments.
It was nice though. Thank you.
So our guest judge has come to a verdict. One of you has scored 8 out of 15 today, whereas the other has scored 6. You both did very well, and it was very hard for her to decide. So today's winner, by 2 points, is Henry. Congratulations on episode 1 win.
Thank you.
Tom, unlucky.
Good game. Okay.
You fucked it.
Just never forget it. Fuck you. Nah.
Why do you think you lost to Henry today?
Because we're shit.
But you only lost by 2 points.
Yeah, I mean, his wasn't the best either, was it? No, let's be honest. We were both pretty shit.
But yeah.
Do you think this is leaving enough room for improvement?
Sure.
That's good. I like your optimism. Henry. Why do you think you beat Tom today?
I shouldn't have.
You believe his was better?
No.
So why shouldn't you have won?
I got 8.
8, yeah.
I don't think that's a passing grade.
Okay, do you believe you can improve?
Maybe.
Okay, I look forward to seeing it. If you two are ready to leave the kitchen for today?
Yeah, sure. Don't ever want to come back here.
Yeah.
Place is a shithole, mate. You need to sort this out.
Hate it here. It's the worst place I've ever been to.
Thanks everyone for tuning in to episode one. We'll see you next time. Goodbye.
This is going to be my magnum opus.
Did you season it?
Yeah.
What was? Avocado.
Were you covering that?
No.
Okay. Good luck.